Hello everyone, let's start exercise 5.2 question number 3. In the adjoining figure, P parallel Q. See, P and Q parallel lines are there. Okay, find the unknown angles. Find the unknown angles. See now here, one angle it is given 125. Then this is E angle. F, A, B, C, D. It is all the angles we have to find. What? Yes, these are all the angles we have to find. Now these are the two parallel lines, P and Q parallel lines, and this is the transversal. See, we have seen these are the parallel lines and this is the transversal. Only this it has shown like this. Yes, these two lines it has shown like this. So transversal has shown this. Okay, so now what it is given, these two lines are parallel. These two lines are parallel. Now see, this angle it is given 125 degree. This angle is, see, these are the parallel lines. And this angle it is given 125 degree. Yes, if these two lines are parallel, see, this angle and this angle, both are corresponding angles. You know which are the corresponding angles already you have learned yesterday. This angle and this angle, corresponding angles. Yes, see, this is the transversal, these are the parallel lines. Now this is the left side of the transversal. Yes, and above of this line. So same way, for this also above of this line and left side of the transversal. So this angle will come 125 degree. Yes, why this will come? So D will come 125 degree. Why? Because these both the angles are corresponding angles. These both the angles are corresponding angles. Okay, so what you will write here? Angle D is equal to 125 degree. Why 125 degree? Because it is corresponding angle. This angle and this angle corresponding. See this, suppose this is 1. This angle and this angle corresponding angles. Okay. So, right here is a corresponding angle. So, which property it is used here? Corresponding angles property. So which property is used here? Corresponding angles property. Understood? Now next, if we got this angle, yes, D we got. Now B we can get. D and B both are vertically opposite angles. See, these both are vertically opposite angles. So angle D is equal to angle B. Angle D is equal to angle B. Why? Angle D is equal to angle B. Now angle D is how much? Angle D is 125. Why these are equal? Because these are vertically opposite angles. These are the vertically opposite angles. Angle D and angle B, vertically opposite angles, and vertically opposite angles are equal. So what will come? Angle B? Angle B is equal to 125 degrees. So here I will write 125 degrees. Okay, so we got this angle. Okay, angle D we got 125, angle B also we have got 125. Okay, now you can find for this angle also, or after finding this angle you will get this angle. Otherwise you can find this angle and after finding this angle you will get this angle E. Okay, so I will show now angle E, how we will get the angle E. See, now angle E we will consider. Now angle E plus angle, which angle? 125. Angle E plus 125 degree is equal to 180 degree. See, 45 degree is equal to 180 degree. Why? Because it has formed the linear plane. See, this is the P, this is the line P, and now see, it has formed the linear plane. See, this is the transversal. So these and this pair, linear pair. So linear pair means its measurement is 180 degree. Yes, 180 degree. And so angle E plus 125 is equal to 180 degree. Because why? Because this is from linear pair. Yes, linear pair, and linear pair's measurement is supplementary. So 180 degree. So angle E is equal to, now this is 180 degree. Now 125 is here plus. We will transfer to right hand side, then it will become minus. So angle E is equal to 180 degree minus 125 degree. 0 minus 5 is not possible. 10 minus 5. Here it covers 5. So angle E, how much we got? Angle E we got 55 degree. Angle E we got 55 degree. Okay. So angle E we have got 55 degree. Now which angle we will now see? Angle A we can make now see here. Angle E and angle A both are equal. Angle E and angle A both are equal because these are the corresponding angles. Because these are the corresponding angles. See here. Angle E. Is equal to angle A. Why? Because these are the corresponding angles. Angle E and angle A, corresponding angles. Okay, so angle E is 55 degree. So angle A also, angle A, therefore angle A is equal to 55 degree. Because angle E, what we have got here? 55 degree. Angle E we have got here 55 degree. Angle E is equal to angle A, therefore angle A is equal to 55 degree. Okay, now next angle A we got. Now C is vertically opposite angle. Now writing here, angle C is vertically opposite angle. See, angle A and C, vertically opposite angles. Yes, so angle A is equal to angle C. Why? What is the reason? Vertically opposite angles. These are the vertically opposite angles. Therefore, angle C is equal to angle A. How much we got? 55 degree. So, angle C also 55 degree. So, angle C also 55 degree. Why? Because these are the vertically opposite angles. Angle A and angle C are the vertically opposite angles. Now, which angle we made? See, this also we got 55 degree. Now angle F is remain. Now which angle is remain? Angle F is remain. Now angle C and angle F, these are also corresponding angles. Angle C and angle F, corresponding angles. Or one more property we can use here, which alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles, see. These are equal, angle F and A. Alternate interior angle, see here, plus form the S. Form the S. So angle F and angle A are alternate interior angles. So angle F also will get 55 degree. Or we can use this property also here. These are the corresponding angles. Angle C and angle F. These are the corresponding angles. Angle C is equal to angle F. Angle C is equal to angle F. Why? Corresponding angles. Why? These are the corresponding angles. So, see, you can use here also, which property now here you can use here to find this angle. You can use here one more property to find the angle F. Which property? Angles made by same side of transversal are supplementary. Angles made by same side of transversal are supplementary. Means 125 plus F is equal to 180 degree. Yes, that also you can use property. So here you can find the answer using suitable properties. Okay. Let's solve question number 4. Find the value of x in each of the following figures if L parallel M. L and M parallel lines and this is the transversal. We have to find the value of x. We have to find the value of x. Now see here, T is the transversal. These angles are made by the transversal. Now this angle it is given 110 degree. So how much it will be this angle? What is the measurement of this angle? We don't know the measurement of this angle. So you consider any letter for this angle. Consider A for this. Consider A for this. So angle A plus 110 degree is equal to 180 degree. Why? Because this has formed the linear pair. So A is equal to 180 degree. Now 110 is here plus. If we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become minus. So A is equal to 180 minus 110, 70 degree. So angle A how much we got? 70 degree we got. Angle A how much we got? 70 degree we got. Okay. Now angle A and angle X, this both the angles are same side of the transversal. See, this both the angles are same side of the transversal. Now see, this angle A is above of this line and angle X is above of this line. Means they are on the same side. Yes? And their vertices, see, these are the different. Okay? So they are on the same side of the transversal and above of these lines. So angle A and angle X, corresponding angles. These both angles are corresponding angles and corresponding angles are equal. So what is the measurement of angle X? So angle X is equal to 70 degree. Why angle X is equal to 70 degree? Because angle A and angle X are corresponding angles. Because angle X is corresponding angle to A. Why? Angle X is corresponding to angle A. Okay, so we got angle X is equal to 70 degree. Okay, now let's solve next example. See, now most of the students confuse in this type of questions. Here only it has asked to find the value of X. Here only it has asked to find the value of X. And now what you all are thinking, these and these parallel lines. These are not the parallel lines. What it is given? L parallel M. Which lines are parallel? These and these. These both the lines are parallel lines. So this is the transversal. Understood? So this is the transversal. Parallel lines which are L and M are parallel. So this is the transversal. So see here, if this is the transversal and these are the parallel lines, so these and these angle corresponding angles. So these and these angle corresponding angles. Yes, most of the students confusing this. They started finding these angles, remaining angles. Very simple way it is given. See, these two lines are parallel lines and this is the transversal. So, see, these angle and these angle. These are, see, same side of the transversal. See, this is the transversal and this is the right side of the transversal. And this angle, 100 degree angle, it is above of this line L. So above this line M, X it is. So both the angles are equal. So angle X is equal to 100 degree. Why? Because angle X is corresponding angle to angle 100 degree. Yes. So what is reason? Corresponding angles. So what is the reason? Corresponding angles. Let's solve question number 5. In the given figure, the arms of two angles are parallel. What it is given? Arms of two angles are parallel. If angle ABC is equal to 70 degree, means this angle if it is 70 degree, then find angle DGC. Which angle we have to find? This angle DGC and angle DEF and angle DEF. Okay. So these both the angles we have to find, this angle and this angle. Now what is given in the given figure? The arms of two angles are parallel. Yes, arms of two angles are parallel. So now we will extend this line. Okay. We have extend these lines. Okay. So suppose these lines are parallel lines and transversal. Okay. So this angle is 70 degree. Yes. These are the parallel lines. This is transversal. So this angle is, if it is 70 degree. So how much angle G? Angle G will come 70 degree. Why? Because these are the corresponding angles. Because these are the corresponding angles or not. So angle G, angle DGC, angle DGC is equal to 70 degree. Yes, angle DGC is equal to 70 degree. Why it is 70 degree? Because this angle is corresponding angles. These and these corresponding angles. So this angle we got 70 degree. So this is also 70 degree. Okay. Now what it is asked? DEF. We have to find this angle. We have to find this angle. Okay. Now what it is given in the question? In the given figure, the arms of two angles are parallel. Means these two arms are parallel. Arms of two angles are parallel. Means these all are parallel lines. See. Now these and these parallel, so suppose this is transversal. Okay, so this is the transversal. Now if this angle is 70 degree, so how much angle will come? This angle also 70 degree, because these and these angles are corresponding angles. So angle DEF also 70 degree. Solve question number 6. In the given figures below, decide whether L is parallel to M or not. Whether L is parallel to M or not. Now in this first figure, after observing, we feel these two lines are parallel. Yes, suppose we will think these two lines are parallel. When these two lines are parallel, interior angles made by transversal on the same side are supplementary. Interior angles, suppose if L parallel M, we'll consider if L parallel M, what it should be in this given figure? Interior angles made by same side of transversal. Interior angles made by same side of transversal are supplementary. Are supplementary. Means this measurement, it should be the 180 degree.
So this measurement should be the 180 degree. Yes. What we have done here, we consider if L is parallel to M. If L is parallel to M, then interior angles made by same side of transversal are supplementary. Let's find this measurement, 126 degree plus 44 degree. How much we are getting? 126 degree plus 44 degree, 6 plus 4, 10. So 4 plus 2, 6 and 1, 7. So what we get the answer? What we got the answer? 170 degree. And 170 degree, which is not equal to 180 degree, it is not equal to 180 degree, means these two lines are not parallel. Therefore, L is not parallel to M. In this figure, L is not parallel to M. Means after observing, we feel these are the parallel. But if you will use the property, which property? Interior angles made by same side of transversal are supplementary. If you will add this both the angles, what we got the answer? 170 degree, which is not equal to 180 degree. Supplementary means it should be the 180 degree, and this is not equal measurement. So these two lines are not parallel. So L is not parallel to M. Now let's solve next example. See, in this example, L and M, these are not the, after observing only we can say these are not the parallel lines. Okay, so if you will extend these both the lines, they meet each other here at one point, means they intersect to each other. Yes. Now if you will observe this figure, see, this is line L, this is line L. Yes. And see, this is N, and here it has formed the linear pair. So we'll consider this angle X. We'll find this angle X. Angle X. This is angle X. So angle X plus 75 degree is equal to 180 degree. Why? Because it has formed the linear pair. Okay. So linear pair. Okay. Why 180 degree? Because it has formed the linear pair. This is straight line and these are the linear pair. So angle X is equal to 180 degree minus 75 degree. Therefore, angle X is equal to, now 0 minus 5 is not possible. Take borrow 10 minus 5, 5, 0, 1. So what we got angle X? Angle X we got 105. See, angle X what we got? 105. And it is not equal to 75 degree. Angle X is not equal to 75 degree. Why? See, if we'll consider this both the lines are parallel, then these both the angles are corresponding angles. Yes, if we will consider these both the lines are parallel, then these both the angles are corresponding angles, and corresponding angles are equal. But if you will see here X, what we got? X we got 105. What we got here? X. X we got 105. So angle X is not equal to 75 degree. So angle X is not equal to 75 degree. What we got? Angle X. Angle X we got 105. And which is not equal to 75 degree. So line L is not parallel to line M. Okay.